Only 4 years old and left on a bus. Good evening. I'm Mike Dardis.
And good evening to you. I'm Cherie Pilello. Tonight, this boy's mother wants to know, how could this happen? WLWT News 5's Terry Daniels talked with that mother and also found out what's going to happen to the bus driver and the monitor. Terry?
Well, Cherie, imagine a young child waking up with no one around. You start crying out for your mother, who thinks you're in school instead of being all alone on a bus on this hot day.
Wee.
Four-year-old Cody Stoltz is happy to be with his mother this evening. Jill Stoltz didn't want to be on camera, but says he deserves to have some fun after a rough day.
He was very upset. He kept telling me over and over again that he was crying for me and that I didn't hear him. So he was upset that I didn't come get him off the bus.
Cody had been at this daycare, and this noon was to be taken by bus to this preschool about 5 minutes away. Instead, Cody fell asleep on this number 3 bus and ended up all alone parked in the Covington School District's transportation lot until a monitor from another bus heard him crying.
It's very hot, and you know, if I had left my son in my car and somebody found him, I'd be in a lot of trouble right now. You know, that's you just don't do that.
The head of Covington School Transportation Department agrees. Ray Finke tells me by phone, it's inexcusable. Forgetting a child is the most serious mistake. The driver and the monitor on board didn't follow procedures to check every inch.
Were you angry?
Yes.
Jill says it took Cody some time to calm down, and fortunately, he's all right physically.
I don't want it to happen. I don't want it to happen to my kids or anybody else's kids. I just want to make sure that you know, they do what they're supposed to do.
Well, both the bus driver and the monitor will face discipline that could include termination. Also, all Covington School Transportation employees are going to be reminded to follow every safety rule to the letter. Mike?